good at the moment. Kate played tennis with Roger Federer. This is very much a contrast with Harry and Meghan, who are perceived to be, as I said earlier, just plain awful. A little strong, perhaps. Neil Sean is a royal watcher, and he joins me now. Neil, I can't see Harry and Meghan going back to Britain anytime soon for anything, can you?
You're very naughty, Stuart, yes. Well, the problem that you have is now, truly, is that Catherine and William are winning. Yesterday, Prince William launched his new homeless charity, which is his sort of bid over the next 5 years to try and at least stem the flow. It's a bold move, let me tell you, and got off to a great start alongside a former Spice Girl, Jerry Halliwell. And then, as you rightly said, we've had Catherine recently popping up, really highlighting some of the good work out at Wimbledon for all the boys and girls who, you know, do all of that. Mm. She's a good friend of Roger Federer, though, and, of course, he obviously likes playing with her. And, you know, when you look at it, you could see this was everything that Harry and Meghan are not doing. It's positivity, it's great role model stuff, and, more importantly, very positive messages out there. The counteract is all we now know about Harry and Meghan is the negativity. And recently, of course, yesterday, a famous talent agent out in Hollywood basically called Meghan talentless. I think that's a bit harsh. But on the other side, I blame, you know, the people who hired them. You gave them the money to buy the name. Did you bother checking whether they could actually do anything? So, you know, it's a double-edged sword, isn't it?
I've got to get back to Prince William doing this homeless initiative. That sounds awfully political to me, and he's not supposed to be involved in politics.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that, Stuart, because that is something that's now slowly rising over here because of that. But what's interesting, if you look at the bigger debate, it's a huge problem, as it is everywhere in the world. Now, obviously, William, you know, stemmed this idea literally from his mother visiting homeless shelters at 11 years old. What's interesting here is perhaps he could cut through with the relevant people where politicians can't. As we know, politicians are not very well trusted in certain matters. People trust Prince William. So I believe he's genuinely thought this concept through. It's one that both has the backing of the King and the Queen. And, you know, whichever way we may feel about it politically, we should applaud the fact that he's actually trying to get something going. And when you think about it, wouldn't it have been great if both he and Harry had worked on this project together? Would have been stupendous, I think.
Very interesting. You're a royalist, I can tell. And I don't blame you either. scroll up the prompter, please. I want to go to the AI in use at Wimbledon story.
Oh, yes.
Wimbledon is going to use AI for commentary during some of the coverage next month. AI-generated audio and captions will be available on the Wimbledon app. How does a royalist, a traditionalist like yourself, feel about that?
Well, you know, I know this now may put you off coming over to Wimbledon at my personal invite, Stuart, you know. This is the problem, champagne, strawberries and cream. No, I think what's quite clever, I filmed out at Wimbledon quite a few times, and the bottom line is it's the whole sort of Englishness about it. It's not gone down well, and when you think also the Lawn Tennis Association Club is the richest in the world, what they're saying is, well, we're not using this on main matches, you know, the big matches, just the outer matches, which basically says, for the lessers, we're not too bothered. We'll try this. Now, if it takes off, I perceive that you and I could be replaced. Also, looking at the bigger picture, you know, I mean, it does sort of say this is the technology, but what a soulless thing, you know. The great thing about any sports commentator, and, you know, I'm not a huge sports fan, but they put such passion, such energy, a bit like yourself, Stuart, into the broadcast. And when you look at it from that point of view, to have a monosyllabic voice telling you, you know, 20, 40, it's not really going to work. But they're pushing ahead and they believe people eventually will accept it. I'm not so sure.
Eventually. That's a long time frame on eventually. Neil Sean, thanks very much for joining us. And I will see you again
soon. A pleasure.
Thank you.